biometric measures emerged from a branch of research, a branch of science, called psychophysiology. Psychophysiology emerged from the psychological sciences and is an interdisciplinary area of research involving psychology, anatomy, biology, neuroscience, as well as these days, even artificial intelligence and computer science in developing models of how the human brain and mind works and functions. Psychophysiology rests on the assumption that variation in physiological signals, such as how fast or slow your heart beats, as well as variation in blood flow in areas of the human brain, can tell us something psychologically meaningful about the state of that individual and how they may be mentally processing important stimuli in their environment, which obviously could include a brand message. So let's take a look at how peripheral branch nervous system measures are collected. So in this specific lab, we're equipped with biometric measures that are associated with variation in the peripheral branch of the human nervous system. The peripheral branch of the nervous system specifically innervates organs such as the heart, as well as glands such as sweat glands on the palm of the hand. Variation in these peripheral nervous system measures has been reliably associated with very important psychological states associated with how individuals respond to a brand message, such as paying more or less attention to the message, feeling more excited or calm during exposure to a message, as well as variation in the emotional experience associated with viewing a brand message. So recording these biometric measures involves the placement of sensors on the surface of the skin. Here on Jamie's face, you can see the sensor placement for facial EMG. Facial EMG records how positive or negative a person feels in response to a brand message. This is the muscle site for recording negative emotion, and these two muscle sites record the experience of positive emotion. We also collect heart rate and skin conductance. Here on the forearms, you can see the placement for recording heart rate. It's just recording a standard ECG signal, and heart rate tells us how much attention a person is paying to a brand message. We also record skin conductance activity here off the surface of the palm. Skin conductance records variation in sympathetic nervous system activity, and psychologically it tells us how calm or excited a person feels in response to a brand message. A noteworthy strength of biometric measures, such as those that we just illustrated, is indeed the ability to record responses, important psychological responses, that occur on an instant-by-instant basis during actual real-time exposure to a brand message. On this screen, you can see how the biometric equipment is recording the three signals that we just illustrated on an instant-by-instant basis. This allows a lab like this to time-lock these signals to very precise instances occurring within a message. That means a lab like this can draw conclusions about how individuals are responding to an entire message, as well as responses to very specific instances within a message that might be psychologically important to determining the effectiveness of the message. Whether you are going to use research that involves the collection of biometric measures and neuromarketing research, or if you're just merely curious about this kind of research, it is important to understand how to separate good science from junk science. A strong scientific paradigm for this kind of research requires that data collection be grounded in an understanding of psychophysiology and the structure and functioning of the human brain and mind. It also requires that researchers don't rely on one or two measures, but rather to get a more complete picture, in fact, actually, the most complete picture possible of how individuals process and may potentially respond to a brand message. It is most valuable to combine biometric measures with all kinds of other quantitative and qualitative data, including data from self-report questionnaires, as well as focus groups and interviews. It's this integrated research approach that is most likely to produce the strongest brand insight, as well as, importantly, valid science utilizing biometric measures.